People that do some wonderful things for great causes, and sometimes the ways they choose to help are pretty unique. Our Elizabeth Campbell has a great story about a guy who really took on a huge challenge.
Meet Christian Lazowski. He says he's your average guy, a hard-working man who loves his family. But he's about to take on something that's not so average, the Marathon du Sable.
This is the original kind of desert stage race founded 30 years ago, and it's a 155-mile race through the Saharan Desert, self-supported, which means that, as I mentioned, everything that I need, with the exception of water and shelter, I'll have to carry on my back.
155 miles, 6 days, through the rough terrain of the Sahara Desert in southern Morocco, with possible temperatures above 100 degrees. The first question you may ask is why?
What kind of piqued my interest was a colleague of mine did a race similar to this and said it was a life-changing event. He was able to really help a charity that he's passionate about. And then, quite frankly, he said, you know, I don't think you can do it.
Christian took that as a challenge and immediately began training for the Marathon du Sable, also known as the toughest foot race on Earth.
You know, we have normal pressures of life. We're not professional athletes. We're not astronauts. We're just normal guys, and he had a challenge to do it and you know, trained and was able to complete it. So that really appealed to me, being able to kind of do something extraordinary just if you put your mind to it.
Christian has been training with the help of a local coach who won the race herself in 1998. He says the mental aspect might be a bit more difficult than the physical.
There's a lot of highs and lows, a lot of aches and pains, a lot of things that happen. And then just to kind of force yourself to keep going when the body wants to stop, you want to stop. Everything makes you want to stop, and you just force yourself to keep moving until you finish.
Not only is he doing the race to prove you can do anything you set your mind to, he's also raising awareness for the Sulzbacher Center, a charity that is special to both he and his employer, Medtronic.
I'm in the healthcare industry. It's something that I'm very passionate about. And so I think many people think the Sulzbacher Center is simply just a homeless shelter and support for the needy. What I think a lot of people would be surprised to know is how much medical outreach they provide to severely underprivileged families, women and children.
Linda Hemphill with the Sulzbacher Center says they were thrilled when Christian reached out to them last fall. Like Christian, she reminds that there's so much more than a homeless shelter.
We also have a fantastic medical clinic that serves not only our residents, but also people in need in the community. There's a clinic at the beach. And Medtronic, who is Christian's employer, has been a wonderful friend to the center for at least 12 years. And they most recently gave a $50,000 gift that goes toward medication for asthma, largely for asthma and diabetes and hypertension. So this is a big help to us.
Christian leaves for Morocco this Tuesday the 5th, with the race starting on the 10th. He says he couldn't do it without the support of his wife, Linda, and two kids, 11-year-old Isabella and 9-year-old Alexander. His family can't be there for the start of the race, but there is something he's really looking forward to.
The really exciting thing that I think will get me motivated through the race is they're going to come to Marrakesh a couple days before, and they're going to meet me on the completion of the race. So I'm very much looking forward to that.
We wish Christian Godspeed, a safe trip. We take it personally with him in his personal quest to achieve his own personal best. And I would ask the community to look at their own goals and things, because you can make a difference.
Good luck, Christian. I'm Elizabeth Campbell for River City Live.
So, 155-mile run through the desert.
Yes.
Like, what's his goal? Like, does he have a goal in a certain amount of time? Or?
So, this is the longest he's ever run, so he says his goal is to finish, yeah, which if he finishes, props to him. My legs are hurting just thinking about it.
Yeah.
But there are more than 1,000 winners. He also says that he's done several marathons and other races within the past 3 years to help prepare him. So, anyone who's interested in donating for his cause, you can head to SulzbacherCenter.org.
All right. Well, thank you. We'll be back right after this.